What's up, guys? Meredith with ExtremeTerrain.com, and today we're checking out the Raxxium Axial Series headlights with a sequential LED light bar with a black housing and a clear lens, fitting all 2012 through 2015 Toyota Tacomas. Now, if you want to restore the look of your headlights on your truck with the addition of extra features that your factory ones were lacking, this set is going to be a great option to consider. Now, not only will this bring more to the table than the factory replacement style options, but these are going to be pretty affordable, so you can enjoy some of the modernization without a steep price point. Now, the set here will keep it fairly simple when it comes to the configuration of the lights, with the large chrome reflector right in the middle with a halogen just like factory, and the turn signal and the marker light are going to be upgraded just in the factory location as well. Now, I think that tame styling really shines through here, offering a very clean appearance that will be sure to bring the light back to the front end, especially if you currently have a fogged lens. This crystal clear lens here is going to make all the difference. Now, the main character of this set of lights, though, is the LED light bar in the center, which adds more of that modern touch and will act as your daytime running light as well as your turn signal. Now, that turn signal, as it says in the name, will also feature a sequential function whenever you actuate it. So ultimately, that's going to make your truck a lot more noticeable when it comes to styling, but it's also going to count when it comes to safety. Now, these will have a tough construction with a black ABS plastic housing and a clear polycarbonate lens on the front, which will offer that crystal clear look, but have the strength to hold up to kick up on the road, any branches or debris off-road. Essentially, they're just gonna be a tough plastic material that's gonna hold their own. This is also going to come with all of the halogen bulbs that you need for every aspect of this light and a factory style harness on the back that is going to be completely plug and play. So you're not gonna have to worry about any wiring here, making the install very easy. Now, these will come in at about $400, which will put these roughly in the middle of the spectrum for pricing. Now, compared to other choices, the hybrid styling here, in my opinion, is a great compromise with the halogen driving lights and the LED accent lighting. Now, that's gonna keep this set affordable while still getting a super clean look and a more modernized upgrade for the front, making these a fantastic choice. Now, install here, again, is gonna be plug and play. These are going to be a bolt-in replacement, so install is gonna get a 1 out of 3 wrenches on the difficulty meter, and it should only take you about 2 hours to get the job done. Now, speaking of the install, one of our customers here has put this on their Tacoma and is going to walk you through what that looks like step by step. So that's gonna wrap it up for me. Let's go ahead and jump into the install.
Just as a final thought here, these are the only tools that I used for the whole process. Couple of hand tools and a tape measure and some tape for the adjustment. There's just a tape measure, Phillips head screwdriver, flathead screwdriver, a ratchet with a 10 millimeter socket and a 10 millimeter combination wrench, plus the blue painter's tape. So a combination wrench with a ratcheting box end could be helpful when adjusting the headlights, getting into those tight spaces, but this is a really simple process with a few simple hand tools that you can get out of almost any home tool set.
Hey folks, my name is Ryan. I've got a 2015 Toyota Tacoma, and I'm planning on swapping out the factory headlights for a set of aftermarket headlights. The 2005 to 2011 model years were pre-facelift. The process should still be the same, but this specific tutorial is gonna be for the 2012 to 2015 model years, which is post-facelift that I have here. A couple of notes before we get started. Safety is important. There are a few steps where we're gonna be underneath the vehicle, just this front end here, so we won't need to jack anything up, but make sure that you have some good eye protection so that you're not getting dust or dirt or rocks in your eyes as you're taking things apart. Second, in terms of tools, all you're gonna need is a basic hand tool set. Everything that we're doing requires just a ratchet or a screwdriver. I would recommend against using things like an impact driver or a powered ratchet. A lot of what we're dealing with is plastic, and we don't want to risk over tightening or cracking things. So with that being said, I'm going to move things out of the way. I've got a table set up here with my tools on it. I will be showing you step by step on what to take off and how to get access to all of the mounting points for the headlights. Let's get started. So to get started here, the first thing that I did was unwrap my headlights out of the packaging that they came in. It's important to inspect your headlights to make sure that all of the mounting points are still attached and that you don't have a potentially defective or damaged product. There's no point in going through all of this work just to have to take it off again to send it back. First step, doing any work under the hood of a car, is obviously opening the hood. Typically, you have a latch inside that you pull and it releases the first step of the latch. Once you have the first step done, there's a little latch here that opens it the rest of the way. It comes up and you want to prop the hood up, making sure that it's stable and not going to fall down on you. The next step we're going to tackle is removing this grill. It should only require a few screwdrivers, particularly a Phillips head and a flat head. Just a few fasteners up on the top. As you can see, one of the fasteners on each side is actually connected to the headlight housing. So you will need to remove that before you can get the headlights out. So it is a good idea to make sure that you have a safe spot to put all of your hardware and your tools. This is why I have the table set up next to me. But to start with, we'll get these two screws out, which hold the grill to the frame of the truck. Set those off to the side. Next step is these fasteners here. They should be Phillips head clips, but you may need to finagle it, especially if the clips are older or if they've been removed previously. So it's a good idea to reach underneath, unscrew it a little bit, and then use the flathead to pull it out the rest of the way. Once it's out, put it somewhere safe. Do the same thing on this side. Push it up slightly. Use the Phillips head for the rest of the flathead for the rest of the leverage. And then just pull it out. With these clips here, they actually use a Phillips head to unscrew. However, if your clips are older or dirty or whatever, they may not come out as easily. So the flathead comes in handy, so you can actually get underneath that top of the clip and use it as leverage when you're unscrewing this. And that simply just pulls out once you have that done. Now, you can't just pull this out right away. You have to push out from the bottom side the actual body of the rest of the clip. Then this simply just pulls away. Same thing on the other side. Now, once you go to remove the grill, you'll notice that as you start to pull it out, it will come unclipped pretty easily. There are a few clips down here, these little black plastic tabs that hold the grill onto the plastic bumper cover. And usually you should just be able to come in here and pop it out just like that. If not, you have to fiddle with the tab until it comes out, but it's fairly easy. Now, I have an aftermarket grill on here, which has lights on it, and I don't want to unplug everything. So I'm just going to leave that up there. It's plenty out of the way, but it gives us access to the rest of the inside parts of the headlights so that we can get those removed. So starting with the driver's side, we have two bolts down here that connect the black plastic inner fender liner to the plastic of the bumper cover. We want to remove those and then unclip the fender liner from inside the back of the front bumper so that we can get access to the mount for the headlight that's actually hidden behind the fender. It is possible to do this by taking the bumper completely off. However, that requires two people, and if you're doing this by yourself, it's a lot easier to just get up underneath the truck rather than removing the entire bumper cover. To do this, it's pretty simple. There are simply two Phillips head screws, and I'll show you those real quick. So as I stated, there are two Phillips head screws, one here and one here, that just hold the liner onto the bumper. So let's go ahead and remove those now. And these are the only two screws or clips that you need to remove to enable you to gain access to that lower mounting point for those housings. And you are going to get a lot of dirt, potentially some rust coming off of these screws and underneath the vehicle. So it is a good idea to put on your safety glasses for this step. Now, these actually do just come unclipped like that. You just got to make sure that there's space where this sits in between the clip, and you just pull it right out. Same thing on this side. It does have a metal, well, it's a plastic bracket there that can just come undone, and you just pull it to the side. So I'll show you the same thing over here. Just got two Phillips head screws. They can be a little tough, especially if you take your vehicle off-roading and get a lot of mud, grime in there. So can require a little bit of force, but since it's a screw going into plastic, you shouldn't have any kind of seizing or other issues going on. And I usually just set these screws on the ground underneath where I'm working. Like I said, there aren't a lot of fasteners, so you don't have to keep track of too many. So once we have those out, you just unclip them and push this aside. And that'll give us plenty of room to get our hand in there underneath the bumper and fender to get to that lower mounting point. Now, this is an odd camera angle, and I apologize for that, but I'm at an odd angle anyway. So, what we're looking at here is inside of the front bumper cover. You've got your inner fender liner here that we pulled back previously. This is your passenger side fog light. And up here is where you can actually see the headlight housing with the lower bracket arm coming down. There are two, let me get my light. There are two fasteners, one of which holds the bumper and the fender together. And the other one is above that right here. And that's a 10 millimeter that you can get a socket onto. My socket requires an adapter to go from the quarter inch to I think a three, no, it might be half inch to quarter inch. I don't know. There you go. And we'll carry on. It is easier if you have, as you can see, I have my adapter there to go to my 10 mil. But stop focusing on my sweater. Focus on my arm hair instead. So using one hand to hold the socket onto the bolt, use the other hand to move the ratchet. Now let's come undone a little bit more. See if we can just get it by hand again. And there we go. Perfect. Just a simple 10 millimeter bolt. And now the lower bracket bolt has been removed, and we'll move on to the other side. Now here we are on the driver's side. It's the same deal. You have the bracket here, which holds the fender onto the bumper, or the fender onto the frame. And then the higher up bolt is where the light housing, the headlight housing, attaches to the fender. So we're gonna grab our ratchet again, bring it up here. And get it on there and just try to break it free. That's the right way. Unfortunately, not being able to see it directly makes it a little bit more difficult. I think it is loose though. Yeah, there we go. This one's being more cooperative. I can just unscrew it with our fingers. And it's out. Don't drop it. Make sure you have a washer still. There we go. It's another standard 10 mil bolt. Once you have those two bolts out, there's a couple of clips that you need to be aware of before you just start pulling the housing up. Two of those clips are up here. The plastic bit that the screw actually goes into will be holding these top brackets in place. So what you want to do, grab a flathead screwdriver or other kind of small prying tool, and you can simply pop it out, do the same thing on this side, and now you have the top part completely loose. There is a third bracket that's down here. It's actually a more robust one that holds this corner of the headlight in place. Take your flathead screwdriver or pry tool again, slip it in behind this piece of the headlight housing and pry it away from that bracket that's on the frame. It is gonna make a loud popping noise, but that's just because it's holding in pretty tightly. Now, if you try to just pull the headlight out, you risk breaking this bracket. So try to pry it gently from the backside if you can. Now, this plastic piece can be in the way, the part that sits underneath the headlight. So it's easy enough to just pop it out from the plastic, the bumper cover, and it just pulls away from the tab on the fender where it sits like that. Now, once that's done, you can lift up on the corner here of the headlight and just kind of shimmy it out of its little hole, making sure that these plastic tabs up here come out safely. It does take some doing, but just be careful, take your time, and keep an eye on all of the corners of the housing to get it out in one piece. Now, that bolt's actually loose. We can try to take this bolt out of the fender and see if we can get ourselves a little bit of extra room by pulling that fender corner out slightly. So now, you have the bolts out, you have the one underneath done, you'll have the clip undone. You're gonna wanna be careful of this tab that the little plastic piece clips into, but now you can bring the whole headlight housing out. Since you didn't take the bumper off, you will have to move it about, finagle it a little bit, but essentially bring this up and out and kind of just rotate it until everything comes loose. Now, one thing I did want to mention is the lower bracket that screws in behind the fender can get caught on the bumper support. But once you have that moved out, you just kind of rotate the housing out. And now it's out of the truck. And we'll pull the other one out next. Same thing on this side. Take the top bolts out. Take our flathead screwdriver. Give these tabs a gentle little pry. Take this tab and do the same thing. Pull it out from behind. We can remove this plastic thing. I don't really know what it's called. Like that. Unplug your lights from behind. It's easier to do that when the housing is actually loose, so you have better access to it all. So you have three different light plugs. There's the turn signal, there's the running light, and then the headlight, the actual headlight. And they all just unclip from the back And again, sometimes it can be handy to get a little pry tool in there to help with removing those lights. As long as you make sure that the clip is removed properly so you're not breaking that off. Once that's done, pops out. Make sure that the wiring harness is out of the way. And same thing as the other side. Pull the housing out over that clip, making sure that your lower bracket is not getting caught on the bumper support. So kind of push that in a little bit. And you're gonna swivel the whole light. Come on, swivel the whole light and then just kind of rotate it out. And that's done. Be careful of your metal bits here because they can be sharp. You don't want to cut yourself. I would advise that you wear some gloves. Sometimes those can get in the way. All right, so now that we have everything taken apart that needs to be taken apart, it's actually a good idea to take a look at everything that sits behind the grill, behind the headlights. Make sure that everything seems to be in order. Make sure that your horn is plugged in. Make sure that your radiator, your AC condenser, your oil cooler, all of that stuff. Maybe that's power steering, not sure. Make sure that everything looks good. You don't have a ton of bent fins or anything. And that way, you're getting some regular maintenance in while you're back here. Next, I want to note that before I put these headlights in, I'm going to be doing some prep on them, namely making sure that the lights that are in the housings are actually going to be in there before I put them into the truck, because it'll be way easier rather than having to reach behind and get in those cramped spaces to replace or change out any of those lights. Now, with the headlights that I got that I'll be putting into the truck, they use the same low beam, high beam bulbs, the H4 or 9003 bulb type, as the factory ones. So you can pull the bulbs out of the factory lights to put into the new bulbs, and I'll show you how to do that real quick. There's a rubber grommet that sits at the back of the bulb that you want to pull off. Now, they can get stuck on there around the bulb base, so it's a good idea to just gently pull that grommet away from the bulb base before you remove it, just alternating which side you're pulling off. And then once it's off, it's off. Make sure that it's clean on the inside, because otherwise that could be an indication that you've got a leak or something where you might be getting moisture or dirt inside of the actual housing. So there's a clip here that you push in and then pull off to the side that will actually come off of the back of the headlight housing. And then you can pull the headlight out. It's really important not to touch the actual bulb with your hands. The oils on your fingers can cause the bulb to overheat and burn out sooner than if it were just clean. Now, I got a new set of bulbs that I'm gonna be putting in my new headlights. Since I'm down here or back here already, I don't see any point in putting used bulbs in new headlights. So I'm just gonna put this in here for safekeeping. Put that clip back on, along with the grommet here. And I will just be putting both the factory headlights off to the side, installing the new lights into the new housing that it's. So now with the new headlights, putting the bulbs in, it's a simple process. Same thing in reverse as I showed you with the factory ones. Now it's a good idea to put something soft down on your workspace so that you're not scratching up your new headlight housings. But what we're gonna do is just pop these new headlights out of their package, being careful not to drop them. Throw that off to the side and recycle it responsibly. So now we're gonna pull this grommet out. This one has the lights coming into it for the modification of the aftermarket lighting setup that it has. So just be wary of that. You're gonna take one of your new bulbs and simply put it in place. Pull the clip aside, put the light in. The middle tab is going to go up because it is directional. And then you just put the clip back in place. Put your grommet back in place. You may have to pull these wires out slightly so that your connectors actually do fit in there properly. Push this in here. And make sure that the grommet is sitting around the light base properly so you get a good seal. And we'll just do the same with the other housing as well. Pull the grommet off. Make sure that the clip is moved to the side. Grab the bulb by its base, put it in the proper orientation, and replace the clip. And we'll put the grommet back in place, making sure it sits against that bulb base properly. And now we're ready to reinstall the housings into the truck. So we're going to start with the passenger side, since that's the last one that we took off. It is going to be the process in reverse of taking them out. So we just want to be careful not to scratch the new lenses that we have. So we're going to tuck this first bracket over this radiator bracket. Take the lower mounting point, make sure that it's tucked in underneath that bumper support bar, and then just gently slide it into place. Just like taking it out, it is going to require a little bit of work to get it in, making sure that we are being careful. You might actually want to put a little bit of tape over this bracket here, just so that we're not gouging our headlights like that. Don't do as I do. Prepare your workspaces. Make sure that the cords stay tucked out of the way. And we're just gonna keep working it in, slowly but surely. And once you have it somewhat in place, make sure your clips are in and you're good to start mounting it. Be sure to take this tape off. So, and now with the driver's side, we'll do the same thing here. And we'll get our this headlights. In. Okay. Well, that was actually a lot easier. Let me show you what I just did. So still being careful of your fender corners. What you want to do, turn it 90, and then tuck the corner in underneath the bumper, making sure that all of the supports on the back end go in underneath the radiator frame support. And then you just want to rotate it like that. See, that's so much easier. And then, same thing, make sure your cords are out of the way though. Tuck those back in there. Get your clips in place, including this bracket down here. And now the two on top. And you're ready to start mounting it again. So now, we're just gonna take our ratchet, and remember, we took the bolt out of the top of the fender here, so we're gonna put that one back in first. So, drop that one. Then we got these two for the headlights. So we'll start both of them and then tighten them up. Okay. And now for this driver's side, we're gonna put our plastic bit back in place, slide it onto that tab, and then just clip it in. Here we go. Now on the passenger side, same thing. Got your two bolts here. We don't need to worry about the fender bolt because I didn't take that one out. Remember not to over tighten anything, especially since we're dealing with plastic threads and plastic clips. Then we got our plastic bit that goes in here. Clip it on to the fender and then snap it into place. Now we're going to install the grill. And like I said, mine's got some wires on there, so we'll make sure that those are out of the way. Remember, we have the plastic clips that are on the bottom, so we're gonna just watch as we stick this in here and just make sure that those clips go in. Check in from the top point as well, and you'll feel those clips go in. There's not a lot of click to them, at least not on my aftermarket one, but you'll know once it's seated. Like that. So now we want to throw our clips and our two screws back in. And I had those over on the table. So with the screws, we'll get those started. And with the clips, if you remember, they're two-piece. So you take the bigger piece, the female end, if you will, and clip that into the headlight housing through the bracket on the grill. And then the male piece just gets pushed in place. And you'll hear that click. And that's how you know it's in place. And we'll do the same thing on this side. Just push that female end in. Male goes into it. Hear that click. And it's in place. Grab your 10 millimeter socket, ratchet, or your screwdriver like we used to take it off, and go ahead and tighten that grill down to the radiator bracket part of the frame. And as you can see, it's just still spinning. Like I said, you don't want to over tighten anything. I've taken this thing off multiple times, so it's likely that once you have the clips on, you take your 10 millimeter ratchet or your screwdriver like we used to remove them in the first place, and just make sure that you tighten these down, making sure not to over tighten them since they are plastic on plastic with a metal screw. And once it's tight, then you're done.
So now we're back here underneath on the driver's side. Hopefully you can see here. What I'm gonna do is grab me the 10 millimeter bolt and just kind of feel for where that bracket is. You may need both hands up here to get the bracket lined up with the mounting point. And it may take a few tries with the washer coming off and trying to keep the plastic bracket in place. So what I did was loosen up the bolts up top just a little bit. To give me a little bit more play getting this bracket set in place. And I'll grab my ratchet. And I'll grab my ratchet. And hopefully this screwed on. Just make sure it's going in okay. You don't want to cross thread it. And depending on which hand is dominant, might make a difference on how easy it is to actually get this in here. And again, two hands might be necessary for it. Okay, it's a little bit too loose to use the ratchet. So driver's side underneath, and I've got this screw barely threaded in here, so we're gonna take our ratchet, make sure it's tightening and not loosening. Oh, come on. Oh, did I just break my ratchet? There we go. So take our ratchet, throw it on that bolt. And it's not gonna cooperate. So let's see if we can thread it on the rest of the way. With my fingers. Take the ratchet. Make sure that it's seated on the nut or the bolt properly, because there's not a lot of clearance and you can't see what you're doing. There we go. And that's that. Now that we've gotten the bottom bracket of the light screwed on, we are going to simply replace the inner fender liner, making sure that it's overlapped correctly, clipping it in place. There, and there. We'll take our two screws and screw them back in. The screw with the bigger washer goes on the inside here. Once we have them hand tight, we'll grab our Phillips head screwdriver and just finish tightening them up. Remember not to over tighten. We're dealing with a lot of plastic. All right, and the driver's side is complete. Okay, now that we're on the passenger side, we just need to get the bracket lined up with the hole, get the 10 millimeter bolt that we took out earlier, and get it threaded. There we go. So what I did have to do was, again, loosen the bolts that were on the top part of the light housing. Now, sorry, my hand is getting me in the way, but I need to get the ratchet . Unfortunately, again, it is there we go. And now we'll go top side and finish things up. So now that we have the bottom bracket bolt in place, we're gonna put the fender liner back together just by sliding them in, clipping them in place, and then once again putting the bolt with the bigger washer on the inside, and then the other one on this side. Just gonna use a Phillips head screwdriver again. Tighten it down. And tighten them down. Okay. Step is to plug in the lights. Now, when plugging in the lights, it should be fairly self-explanatory. They are not they're unique for each plug. I know it may be a little bit, maybe even impossible to see down here, but I can't even see, so. Okay, so the headlight's plugged in. We have the turn signal, which actually goes to the LED light bar. So that one, we need to find the
lug, which is right here. Just gotta fish that through. Go. It gets plugged in. And then we have this plug. So the clip goes on the outside of the light like this. And it's clearance is a little bit close to that fender support, so it does need some coaxing to get it. You hear the click, and we are in. And I'll just gently move you over to this side. Gently move you over to this side. And we'll do the same thing over here. Move the light so both of us can see. It's a little bit more clearance on this side next to the battery. So we'll find the turn signal light. Plug. We've got the headlight connector. And then remember, the marker light is the clip on the outside. So let's do the marker light first. Clip goes to the outside. Let's try to get in there like this. This one, it looks like the clip is on the inside, actually. Hear the click, and you are good. I'm gonna plug the headlight in. Sorry, my big head's in the way. I'll also plug the headlight in. We're done. There is one big important step left to do, and that is to adjust the headlights. And I will show you how to do that shortly. It's a new day, so I had to wait until it was a little bit brighter outside. But I'm gonna show you how to adjust your headlights. And obviously they're not on, but I did want to make a caveat to my earlier statement about tools. In order to adjust your headlights, it's advisable to get a tape measure and a roll of tape, and make sure that you have a good spot to go that has a level ground and a perpendicular wall. So the first step in adjusting your headlights is you want to pull your vehicle as close to a wall as possible. I have a mostly flat driveway, so I'm doing it here against my garage door. And then you want to turn your headlights on. And we're actually going to be marking where that low beam is against the wall, the reference wall that you're going to be using. So we're going to take our tape, as we mentioned earlier, take a small piece, and we're going to mark it horizontally where that beam is sitting. And then we'll take a longer piece, and we're going to mark vertically where the center of that beam is hitting. Next step is we're going to want to reverse the vehicle away from the wall, keeping it as straight or centered as possible. You want to consult your owner's manual to see how far away from the reference wall your vehicle should be when adjusting the headlights. I wasn't able to find it in the 2015 Tacoma operator's manual that I have. But I did see a reference online that they require or refer to 10 feet for Toyotas. I am going to use a 10-foot reference so that hopefully you can see what I'm doing a little bit better as I am instructing this video. So now, as you can tell, once I've pulled my vehicle far enough away, I have my headlight beams are showing against the reference marks that I made. The passenger side is up a little bit too high and out from the vehicle. The same thing on the driver's side. Now, each of these headlights, both the left and the right, have two adjustment points. This first adjustment point on the upper side is for bringing the headlights in or out from the side of the vehicle. Then you have an adjustment point down lower, if this will focus, which will turn the beam up or down in reference to the ground. So in order to adjust this headlight here on the driver's side, I'm going to tighten this bolt here, which will bring the headlight inward toward our reference tape. And once we have it relatively close, we can move on to up and down. Now, on both sides, tightening the headlight adjustment for the left and right will bring it in closer towards the center of the vehicle. Now, it'll be hard to show you guys a movement of this adjustment point, so you just have to believe me, but I'm going to get in here. As you can see, as I tighten this lower adjustment point screw, it is lowering the light in reference to our horizontal tape mark. And once we get it lined up there, that looks about right, we'll move on to the next side. Now this driver's side is going to be a little bit trickier. We have our top point here for adjusting in and out, and then down here you can see the up and down adjustment. So same thing, I will tighten this screw here to adjust the headlight in and out, and this one didn't need quite as much. Now what we're going to try to do is squeeze our hand down in here, and since we need to go down, we are going to tighten headlight adjustment bolt down there as well. And if you do have a low profile ratchet or even a ratcheting wrench like this where it has the ratchet on the box end, highly advisable since there is very minimal room. Now as you can see, I did have to pause it because unfortunately that last screw adjustment took a while, but both of my headlights now have a beam that sits in the center of my reference point of tape on the door. Now it's important to check this at night. Like I said, you get a much better, more accurate pinpoint for your beam pattern. But once it gets dark, I will show you how you can double check this light and see if you need to make any further adjustments. And that, my friends, is how you adjust a pair of headlights. Remember, adjust them as needed. It may not be totally correct on the first try. Test them out, make sure that they're functioning correctly, make sure that your adjustment screws are actually staying in place. Just a good idea to keep an eye on it as you would with everything else on the vehicle.
So that's going to wrap it up for my review and the install of these Araxium Axial Series headlights with the sequential LED light bar, black housing, and clear lens fitting all 2012 through 2015 Toyota Tacomas. And you can find these right here at extremeterrain.com.